everybody. Welcome to the Dennis Prager Show. Today is a disgusting day. It's called May Day. Anything that celebrates communism is despicable. And very fitting, by the way, today Prager University is releasing a video. Why isn't communism as hated as Nazism?
When people describe particularly evil individuals or regimes, why is it that they use the terms Nazi or fascist, but almost never communist? Given the unparalleled amount of human suffering communists have caused, why is communist so much less a term of revulsion than Nazi? Communists killed 70 million people in China, more than 20 million people in the Soviet Union, not including about 5 million Ukrainians, and almost one out of every three Cambodians. And communists enslaved entire nations in Russia, Vietnam, China, Eastern Europe, North Korea, Cuba, and much of Central Asia. They ruined the lives of well over a billion people. So why doesn't communism have the same terrible reputation as Nazism?
May Day celebrations. Do you know that the Los Angeles Unified School District debated whether to take the day off, whether students in L.A. would not go to school, teachers would not teach on May Day? May Day. Wow. I'm telling you, the left is so powerful in this country, and it celebrates such terrible, terribly immoral things. I really do wonder if the average, I wonder how many sophomores, and I'm just thinking, it could be seniors, it's irrelevant. How many students at Princeton have a clue as to how many people communism killed in the 20th century? I would say that I would be shocked if 10% of Princeton students, and I'm just using Princeton because it's an elite school, it doesn't matter what school, it's irrelevant. It's just not taught. So you see people wearing, you know, Che Guevara t-shirts. Amazing. It's amazing. Celebrate a killer on your shirt. Yeah, the LAUSD thing is an amazing story. They actually considered, this is the Los Angeles Daily News. Some LAUSD employees vow to march on May Day even though schools are open. Though the Los Angeles Unified School District will be open and operating Monday, that's today, the day planned for a massive downtown march for immigrant and workers' rights. Workers' rights. What rights don't have workers have in the United States? What rights don't immigrants have in the United States? Now that I think of it, what right don't you have? You don't have rights if you're an illegal immigrant. If you sneaked into the country and violated our border, then you don't have rights. I mean, you have elementary human rights. Nobody can murder you, God forbid. But rights? Some district employees aren't planning to come to work on May Day. District employees represented by SEIU Local 99 will use personal time to miss work on Monday so they can participate in the march organized by the May Day Coalition of Los Angeles, a network of about 100 immigrant and worker organizations. Well, 100? How many organizations are there in this country? About 50 district workers represented by the union will participate, and they could include bus drivers, classroom assistants, custodians, and cafeteria workers. The leader of the United Teachers Los Angeles, so that's the teachers' unions of L.A., right? The union representing district teachers had asked Superintendent Michelle King to close the district for the May Day march. You hear that? That's what I opened up by telling you. The teachers' union asked to close schools on May Day. You think the left has taken over teachers' unions? It's not even an attack. It's just a fact. Take off May Day. So we don't have Columbus Day, but we will have May Day. Because Columbus Day, irrespective of what Columbus did or and didn't do, vis-a-vis indigenous peoples, and there are some terrible things, and I fully acknowledge that. Nevertheless, the issue about Columbus Day is not about that specifically. It's really about, do we celebrate Western civilization? That's really what it was about. But we do celebrate May Day here. That's amazing. It was debated. After careful deliberations and a balancing of the many perspectives shared, this is Michelle King, superintendent of the Los Angeles Public Schools. After careful deliberation and a balancing of the many perspectives shared, we arrived at the conclusion that LA Unified Schools and offices will remain up and running on May 1st. At the heart of this decision is our unwavering commitment to keep kids safe. Do you understand that? They're not going to close schools on May Day so as to keep kids safe. Where aren't they safe? Schools continue to be the safest places for students to incubate an interest in civic engagement. In other words, you know, what does it mean? What does it mean, incubate an interest in civic engagement? It means to march for left-wing causes. You know what you need when you hear leftists speak? You need subtitles. And we encourage all schools to use May 1st as an opportunity to discuss matters of civic importance. In other words, it's a good chance to indoctrinate the kids further into left-wing thought. That's what it is. This is the superintendent of the second largest school district in the country, to the best of my knowledge. Organizers are expecting at least 100,000 people to participate in the Monday march from MacArthur Park to City Hall. I have to tell you, I am not the only one thinking this way. In fact, this is one of the handful of things left and right both agree on. We're all amazed that there are still so many Americans who vote Republican. They must be very frustrated on the left. They've taken over the news media. They've taken over the entertainment media. They've taken over elementary schools, high schools, colleges, and postgraduate. And they've taken over much of religion. And all these people are still voting Republican. And Donald Trump is president. I mean, they must scratch their... Where are all these voters? By the way, I say the same thing. Where are all these voters? I admit it. I say a similar thing to the left. Given how much they have taken over, it is mind-boggling that there are still people voting otherwise. I love that the president did not go to the White House Correspondents' Dinner. I can't tell you. I hope he shows up at none of them. They're so filled with themselves. Oh, the media. Oh, my God. Oh, it's painful.